The following exercises are suitable for these prosthetic knee joints. Apart from that, always consider the user's physical condition. Building the trust to put full weight on a flexed knee joint is a fundamental step for handling different situations of everyday life, for example, walking downhill. Franziska and Gerhard show how to learn and refine the technique called yielding. Gerhard lets the knee joint yield as he applies his weight. He feels the resistance against knee flexion and consciously rolls over the foot. When practicing without holding onto the bars, the amount of yielding into knee flexion is determined by his ability to bring the knee back into extension. Gerhard can also use the yielding for going backwards. In order to do this, he slightly pushes into the prosthetic knee joint while stepping back with the contralateral leg. Gerhard learns a yielding step. He uses the stance flexion resistance to cross a small obstacle. Franziska supports the knee flexion and accurate timing right at the knee joint. Gerhard should allow the knee flexion when the contralateral leg takes a step forward. The exercise should be done without holding onto the bars as soon as Gerhard feels secure. This exercise is a good preparation for walking downhill using the yielding technique. Gerhard trains an even walking rhythm. Before walking down a slope, he can focus on the right technique and timing between the parallel bars. Colored ground markings or numbers are necessary for the next exercise. Franziska names the color which Gerhard should hit when he lunges forward. The aim is to yield into knee flexion as far as he is able to control the movement. The intensity of the exercise can be raised by increasing the speed. Franziska decides to use a medicine ball to further improve Gerhard's training. At first, Gerhard should use the yielding technique only when throwing the ball. Later, he should also use it when catching it if necessary. The aim is to intuitively use the resistance to absorb movements and to avoid a high impact to the hip joint. The movement should look smooth and dynamic. Franziska shows Gerhard how to stop a movement using a yielding step. He yields into the knee joint and uses the resistance to slow down the movement. The contralateral leg is relieved. This is also possible for higher velocities. Franziska demonstrates how the active knee flexion is used to absorb the landing for small jumps. It is easier to learn the motion pattern on slight slopes because the knee flexion happens nearly automatically. Gerhard should leap over the white marking. The aim is to land as smoothly as possible. Immediately after landing, Gerhard allows knee flexion to occur, or rather slightly yields into the joint. Avoid knee extension during landing. It is important to have a good fitting socket and an adequate stance flexion resistance to avoid pain during movements and to provide proper support. Franziska places an obstacle on the floor. Additionally, Gerhard has to overcome the passive resistance of the prosthetic forefoot when landing. To absorb the impact of the landing, he now has to yield into the knee more actively. If the center of mass is shifted backwards when landing on the heel, it is harder to generate knee flexion, especially since a long residual limb causes knee extension torque. Gerhard must try to shift the center of mass forward quickly towards the midfoot area.